thinking, mind, and creativity, three concepts, as you know, that have always been fundamental. The tendency today, however, is to consider thought as much less important than action, of such little importance, in fact, that we are increasingly delegating it to the machine. This idea of letting machines think for us, besides confirming a simplistic and reductionistic view of mind itself, reinforces the paradigm of our hyper-technological civilization, which runs the risk of treating social system as mechanism and reducing politics to technocracy. Without the human thought, how can we light up our minds or kindle our capacity for creativity? Another critical point regards the logics of separation and closure that characterize our educational and training institution. As I've been saying for years, unfortunately, our educational and training institutions promote, in theory, multi-inter-transdisciplinarity and a complexity approach and vision. But in reality, as you know, they are hindered by rigid separations between disciplinary sectors. The problem, as you know, is not the specialization of knowledge. The problem is that we have created the conditions for knowledge and skills not to dialogue. And I think that it's a long and complex road. The question for discussion about thinking are as follows. Question number one, in what sense is the way we are thinking now and the way we are educating youth to think today part of the problem? And how does it manifest in the way and the type of knowledge generation, knowledge dissemination, and the social impact and consequences of knowledge in life? This question directly links the way we think to education and the challenge of human security and sustainability. So question number two, what change in thinking and education would we need to inculcate to overcome the limitation and deficiencies of our present mode of functioning? And the third question is, the work of the academy has been emphasizing the need for a shift to a concept of reliable knowledge with its context sensitive, comprehensive, organic, integrated, value-based, cognizant of both objective and subject dimension of reality. How will educational content and pedagogy need to change in order to guide and encourage a way of thinking needed that we do or than we have in the past?